us get this video done with. Hey, what's up guys, it's Winter and Snow, also known as Ashley Ann, and welcome back to another one of my videos. So today we are going to be looking at language, but not just anything to do with language. We're going to be looking at exactly why it would be impossible for a person to single-handedly create an entire language of their own. Wait till the end. If you know me, you know that I am in love with my languages. Right, there's that much to consider when actually looking at a language. So, when looking at language, what is language? Language is communicating. You're talking to people. This is expressing yourself, your thoughts, your ideas, your opinions successfully to another person so that they can understand you and see your point of view. That's language. So, let's get into it. Number one, time. Time. Who's got time to actually look into making an entire language of their own? Just thinking about how much time would be required to actually build an entire language is simply heartbreaking. What time would you have to actually create it? You actually have to first think of a couple of things, and here are a couple of things or other aspects that you're supposed to consider when creating a language. Let's start with the basics. Alphabet. The first thing you need in every language is an alphabet. What kind of alphabet? Not only are you going to have to think of an alphabet, you're going to have to come up with the vocabulary of each and everything that actually exists. So this is from dirt to sky, to the names of the birds, to the names of people, to the names of body parts, books and things, walking, jumping, swimming, working. So you would have to name each and every single thing that exists. Who's got time to be doing that? Not only are you supposed to name every single little thing, you have to find vocabulary that touches on every single aspect of human living. And this includes home, work, everything in between. You got a lot of work on you, a lot to think about, a lot to do. So, supposedly you magically are able to name all those things, okay? You probably have to translate an entire dictionary with the alphabet that you have created. The next thing you're gonna have to look at is spelling. How are you gonna spell in your language? First of all, you're gonna have to first figure out which alphabet are you gonna use, okay? Are you gonna use the normal standard English alphabet A to Z, or are you gonna use like something like the Russian alphabet, or are you gonna be like Chinese and Japanese whereby you use different characters? Which alphabet are you gonna use, and how you're actually gonna spell those things, okay? Hand in hand with spelling, you're gonna have to look at something called phonology. Phonology, this is basically how your language is gonna sound like, okay? Are you gonna be like Korean, which uses a lot of double vowels? Are you going to be like Japanese and Shona, which uses a lot of vowels and consonants, pairs, basically? Right? Or are you gonna be like English and French and words that mix some dependency on a combination of consonants and vowels? So you have to think about all that while creating your words. Magically get the time and are able to create an alphabet, are able to come up with the vocabulary, are able to spell all these words. Next thing you're gonna have to look for, let me tell you, is grammar. Grammar is like the backbone of any language, and it is already stressful enough to keep up with the grammar of a native person's language. Like, your native language has got grammar rules, and it's got a certain, you know, way of dealing with grammar that is very unique and different. So when it comes to grammar, most people just grow up with a certain, you know, grammar, and the way we say things is grammatically corrected as we're growing up. So grammar is basically embedded into us, even though sometimes we still, as native speakers of a certain language, make grammatical errors. So the first thing to look at when it comes to grammar is word order. When it comes to word order, each language has got a specific word order or rule of word order that it follows. English, Chinese use the subject, verb, object word order. Languages such as Korean and Japanese and Greek use a subject, object, verb. Those two are the two main like word orders that are used in the whole world. But then there are actually four other word orders that are used. Some not so much, some more less than others. You're gonna have to decide the word order for your language and stick with it though sometimes they can be exceptions, things like couplas whereby this is that. Some languages, like I said, have the exception. So you're going to have to decide whether or not you want your language to have that exception or not. And if it's going to have that exception, you're going to have to decide how it's going to be brought out. So good luck. The biggest hurdle in ever creating a language. Conjugation. This has to be my biggest nightmare when it comes to learning any language. Conjugation. Why does conjugation have to be so freaking hard? First thing to look at when looking at conjugation is decide whether or not in your language you want both nouns and verbs to be conjugated. Because in some languages such as French, nouns are conjugated. In languages such as English, no, nouns are not conjugated. After looking at whether or not these nouns and verbs are going to be conjugated, or whether one is going to be conjugated and the other is going to be left, you're going to have to find a way of conjugation for each and every word that you came up with in the vocabulary. So this would mean nouns and verbs. Good luck. Conjugation is made in order to match the subject of the sentence that is used in that current situation. If you do not understand what that means, basically, it is like this. I speak English, my French is terrible, and so I am not familiar with the conjugation of nouns, but I am familiar with the conjugation of verbs. Stemming from the word break, you know the words breaks, broke, broken, and breaking. From the words such as work, work, working, works, worked, etc. This is basically giving a verb a past tense form, present tense form, future tense form, etc., etc., etc. Because we have other forms such as past, present, past, future, present, past tense, present, future tense, etc, etc, etc. You're gonna have to come up with a conjugation for each verb or each noun that you have, apparently. A conjugation form. And each conjugation has got its own set of rules. For example, sometimes the spelling of a word can completely change when given a certain conjugation form. Grammar and conjugation will probably be the biggest hurdle in creating any language. How many different scenarios would you have to create and go through in order to successfully conjugate each and every single word that you have in your vocabulary? Each and every language has got certain exceptions which do not follow the normal rule of grammatical conjugation. And so in the end, those rules have to also be stated and listed. Good luck with that. Basically, conjugation and grammar confuses the heck out of native speakers already, and no native speaker is actually perfect in their language, because there are some words probably in your own native language that you've never heard before and that you might come across later on in the future. So how are you so sure that you as a human being, as an individual, are able to touch on every single aspect of human living and do it perfectly? At this point, your chances are 1 to the power of infinity. Let's say you magically are able to get past all of these hurdles. There are still more elements that you have to consider. Now, let me just name a few. Consider whether or not your language has got gender. Some languages have gender, some languages don't. Is there a different way of counting things? For example, in English, you can count anything and everything exactly the same way. It's one car, one pen, one pencil, one bus, one bed. But in Japanese, it is completely different, because you cannot count long things the same way you count short things. You cannot count short things the same way you count big things. You can't count big things the same way you count round things. You also have to look at state of being, referral to humans and referral to things. Usually there's a distinction between naming an object and naming a living creature. You're gonna have to decide in your language where that boundary of living thing is and where that boundary of object is. Another thing you'd have to look at is pragmatics and use of honorifics, casual speech, formal speech. In English, it's not as clear, the line between formal and casual, but in other languages, it is clear, and there is a clear boundary on what is casual, what is formal, what is rude, what is polite. So you are going to have to decide the boundaries on what is rude, what is polite, whether there's casual speech, formal speech. So good luck with that. That's another thing you can look out for. You're gonna have to also decide what is an accent and what isn't, what sounds native and what doesn't sound native. Your language would have only one native speaker, which is you, the one who actually created that language. You are going to have to think of all this, right? Make the necessary choices to actually then create a basis of your language. And still, even after all that effort, it is unlikely that your language is even going to be anywhere near perfect. When you're done creating that language, newsflash, you're gonna be the only one who knows that language. So you're gonna have to start teaching people from scratch a new entire language. So yeah, good luck with that. The last thing, I keep the best for last. We're gonna need a Bible for this one. As a language learner, one thing that I was really curious about is where language actually came from. I started actually knowing where language came from my little sister. I was just like, hold up, run that by me one more time. How did I not see this? So flip all the way to Genesis 11 verse 7 to 8. Come, let us go down and give them different languages so that they won't understand each other's words. So in that way, God scattered them all over the earth, and that ended the building of the city. All my questions on this topic were answered. I was just like, you know what? It makes total sense now. This world has more than 2,000 different languages, and they were all created in one moment. So you can see just how big of a scope creating a language actually is. If you were ever thinking of doing that, I mean, like, you could always give it a shot. I don't guarantee you'll get the results that you want. Probably die before you get anywhere with it. Anyways, guys, that is all for my video. That is why humans just basically cannot create their own language. That was it for the video. Leave a comment down below about what your favorite language is, whether you're learning a new language or not, whether you want to learn a language. Also, like, what your favorite language is, what you like about the language. Y'all know where to talk in the comment section. Anyways, guys, that's it for the video today. If you guys like the video, please don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up, like, share, and subscribe, and leave a comment in the comment box below, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Dakara, tsugi made ni minasan ja mata ne, bye. Bye.
Epilogue.
I don't know anymore. So how you like that? On point, period. We gon' like that, da-da-da-da. Man, I love this verse. A whole new world. Verse. With a tiny little bookmarker. Save this page. Save this page. Save the page. Wow, I have filled up my storage. This is gonna kill me on editing. Too. I was supposed to sneeze. I do not know what the plural scissors is. Grammar. Arabian? Okay, moving on. And you know what? Ugh. Whee.